Hey, you guys, it's the Foxy JA47, you guys. How's everyone doing? It is sunny outside, but it's still like really, really cold. And it is late in the evening, so I don't think I have much of sunshine that's left. Because, you guys, I took a Benadryl today. One Benadryl I took today. And I couldn't figure out, like, Benadryl is not new to me. I know about Benadryl, okay? But I took one Benadryl. Usually Benadryl don't bother me. I could take two Benadryls and drive, and it does not bother me. It does not make me, I'm sorry about the sunshine, you guys. I'm sorry about the sunshine. But I can normally take Benadryl and do not have a problem. Let me put my seatbelt on. Do not have a problem with Benadryl. But anyway, it is late in the evening. The sun is still shining. But as I said, it's getting ready to come down because it's late. I took a Benadryl and I started feeling really, really sleepy and tired today. I'm saying, what is wrong with me? But little did I know, I forgot that I had took the Benadryl. But like I said, usually when I take Benadryl, I mean, it doesn't bother me at all, period. So, yeah, but anyway, so I'm waking up late and I'm just hitting the road because, you know, that's my favorite. That's my favorite spot is in my car. It's my favorite spot. Yes. So anyway, what's going on? I hope everyone had a wonderful day because my day is almost over. But anyway, I hope you had a wonderful day. I hope you did something prosperous today. I hope that you did something today that you have never done before. Something that you wanted to do and you never got up enough willpower to say, I'm going to do this today. So I hope that you guys got up enough willpower to say, I'm going to do this today. But anyway, you guys, so you know what? This is what I want to talk about today. Like I said, I'm sorry about the sun and everything, how it's doing. But this is what I wanted to talk about today. Because this is a touchy-touchy situation, you guys. And I've heard so many men, I've heard so many women talk about this, and it's a touchy situation. It's a type of situation where I think that people really don't be honest. They don't really, like, be true. They don't really, like, just come on out and tell the truth. Tell the truth and shame the devil. I know the way things sound sometimes that it may not sound good to other people, but we in this world now have to not worry about what sounds good to other people. We in this world, we got to worry about what sounds right to us, what we think is right, okay? Yeah, because so many times we worry about other people, what they're going to say. So many times I've held back. See, I'm going in left field now, but I'm going to come back to where I'm going. So many times I have held back in my life things that I wanted to do, things that I wanted to say, things that I believed, and I didn't let them come forth because of what I felt like other people would say. And what I feel in my senior year, that's what it is. I'm not a baby. 57 is my senior year. I'll be 58 in April. That's my senior year. Whether I want it to be or not, hey, that's what it is. So in my senior years, I have found out. Wow, I'm looking at this lady house right here. I'm going to come around to what I'm going to say. I was looking at this lady house right here, and she was in the hospital and she passed away. Well, she was in the hospital and the doctors told her that there was nothing else that they could do for her. Now, I really don't know what she was going through while she was in the hospital, and she wasn't in there a long time because I've seen her and I've spoken with her. I talked with her. She was, I guess, like an evangelist, something like that. But she was in the church. She was evangelist, reverend, whatever they called her. But anyway, I hadn't seen her just a little while. I had not seen her, and I was wondering where she was. But then I heard the other day that she was in the hospital, and the doctor discharged her and said that there was nothing else that he could do for her. And this lady, now how many can do that? This lady checked out of the hospital, went to the funeral parlor. My God. Went to the funeral parlor, paid her money for her burial, picked out her clothes for her burial, took care of everything for her burial, so that when she passed away, nobody would have to struggle and worry about her. She did everything. She picked out everything she needed to pick out for her funeral, and she died, I think, like 2 days later. My God, from Zion. Oh, you talking about some strength and power. That lady had some strength and power. I don't think I could have done it. Okay. I just want to throw that out here because I was passing by her house and it's sitting there. And she didn't have any kids. House is sitting there. I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to get off of that because I know me, I get stressed like really quick. And I will. That's who I am. I get stressed. I take on other people's problems and other people's burdens like really quick. And I know I shouldn't do that, but that's who I am. So, whoosh. I just want to say that I was coming past her house. So, anyway, we're going to leave that alone. But where we're going at now is, I see it's a little bit brighter now, but it's going to turn darker again. But where we are going at now is, I know that it is kind of strange. And I know that a lot of people don't want to admit it. And it's kind of strange. But what I want to know is, your mother is drowning and your wife is drowning. Both of them are in deep water. Now you tell me. I know this is a rough situation. It's rough. This is for the man as well as the woman. This is not just for the man. If your wife is drowning or your husband is drowning, my God from Zion, both of them are in a pool of water and they are drowning. You tell me, you guys. You tell me. The man let his wife drown. The woman let her husband drown to save her mother and to save his mother. My God from Zion, this is a touchy situation. And men, so many times they say, I wouldn't let you drown. Women tell men, same, because I'm going to say both, because if I just stick with men, because I'm a woman, then I know some men are going to say, women do the same, which is true. So, which would you let drown? At least tell me what you think. Now, I know when a situation come upon you, then I know things will be different. What you say you would do, you find yourself not doing. And what you say you wouldn't do, you find yourself doing. Or what you say you would not do, you find yourself doing. Whatever. You know what I'm saying. So, what would you do if your mother was drowning and your husband was drowning? My God from Zion, which one would you allow to drown? I know. Woo! I know that's a tight one right there. But out of your own mind right now, I know things may change, but which one would you let drown? Would it be your mother? Or would it be your father? Or would it be your sister? Would it be your brother? No. But would it be your wife or would it be your husband? This is a touchy situation. So I heard that the man, it was his mother and his wife, and they were drowning. And I heard that the wife was reaching for the husband, hollering and screaming for him to save her. The mother was hollering and screaming for her son to save her. So I know that that was a sticky, like, emotional time. Like, my God, from Zion. So he saved his mother. And he let his wife drown. He saved his mother, so he let his wife drown. So, wow. Sticky right there. That's a rough thing right there. That's probably hard for some of you guys to answer. Then probably some of you guys, you got your husbands or your wives watching the video. So, of course, you probably wouldn't say. But that's okay, too. I understand that. So, I heard about that. I want to do this video right quick because that was something that was on my mind. So, I was like, okay, I'm going to bring this before you guys. I'm going to bring this before you guys and you tell me what in the world do you think that possibly you would do? What would you do? Would you let your wife drown? Or would you let your mother drown? Or would you let your mother drown and save your husband? Which one, you guys? I'm just taking a poll. I know it's hard. I know it's hard to say which one. I know it's hard to say which one. Because which one would I allow to drown? My partner would have to go down. I'm just being real. I'm just being real. My mother is not here now. She's gone. But my God from Zion. It would definitely have to be my husband, my boyfriend, my boo, my Tululu, my partner. He would have to go down. Hey, you know what? I'm not going to pretend. You know, and say, oh, no, I wouldn't let, oh, no, oh, yeah, I'm just saying it straight up. I'm sorry. I love my boo or whoever to Lulu, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry, baby. You got to go down. I'm sorry. So anyway, oh, boy, this is touchy. This is touchy. But I just wanted to know from you guys, what do you think about this? What do you think? You don't even have to say what you would do. If you want to say it, I would like to know. But if you don't want to say it, you don't have to. But I just want to know your response on this. Okay, you guys. That's all I have to say about that. I just want to know because that kind of got to me a little bit when I heard about that. It kind of got to me. I heard about it some years ago. I'm sorry for chewing, but it's good. I heard about it some years ago, but to really like hear about it, like this really happening. Well, I heard about it really happening. And what you guys think? Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think and share this video. With anybody that you feel like you want to share this video with, share it with them. Share it with your mama, your sister, your brother, your cousin, your auntie. Share it with everybody. Get back with me, you guys. And that being said, I'm not going to hold you guys any longer. So, just thumbs this video up. Give this video a big old thumbs up for old school. Because old school is still on the run. Old school is still moving. So, thumbs this video up for old school. And I'll talk to you guys later. And if you're not a friend of my page and you are just stopping by, come back and check out old school. Okay? Get old school a thumbs up. Old school still moving. Old school still got spunk in her. Woo! Nah, okay? Okay, I'll talk to you guys later. Peace and much love. Mwah! Love you guys. Bye.